تتنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر تنزل الملائكة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. Continuing with our beautiful discussion on the significance of Laylatul Qadr, a hadith that I would like to make a reference to in commencing with our discussion today. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has made reference, he who fasts in Ramadan, he who stands in Ramadan, he who stands in Laylatul Qadr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." He also said, "Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." He also said, "Man qama Laylatul Qadr imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." He who fasts in Ramadan, his sins are forgiven. He who stands in Ramadan, his sins are forgiven. He who stands on Laylatul Qadr, all his future sins are forgiven. Ulama say, scholars say, each one is a safety net for the other. Meaning if you missed one, the other one will make up for the other. Now just like we say, if you have gone for Hajj, you are the guest of Allah. Similarly, when you have achieved Laylatul Qadr, Allah has something special destined for you. And if you have been deprived of it, it would mean that there is some reason, there is some sin of yours that is depriving you of this night. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of Rasulullah, says, when the last night of Ramadan commenced, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر الأحيى الليل وأيقظ أهله وجد وشط المنظر. In the Sahihain, the two correct books of hadith, it is reported from the hadith of Aisha that when the last 10 days and nights of Ramadan came, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would stay up at night. He used to wake his family and gird his loins. She added, he strove hard and girded his loins. The tafsir of this surah would commence now, insha'Allah. One of the most interesting signs of the tafsir is the interrelationship or the interaction between the various surah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر.
You know, just listening to these words of the Quran Kareem inspires us not to lose out on this night. Now we commence today, insha'Allah, with the commentary of the surah, in order for us to get a great and a beautiful and a comprehensive understanding of the significance of this night. One of the most interesting sciences of tafsir is the interrelationship or interconnection between the various surah. The relationship or the relation of this surah to the previous surah. The previous surah, Surah Alaq, began explaining how revelation began. This surah addresses when revelation was sent down. Surah Alaq started with, he taught man what he knew not. عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. Surah Qadr, what will make you know what the night of Qadr is? Meaning, you did not know what the night of Qadr is. You only found out because Allah taught it to you. The last ayah of Surah Alaq is, وَسْجُدْ وَقْتَرِبْ, and bow down in sajda and come close to me. وَسْجُدْ وَقْتَرِبْ, prostrate and draw near to Allah. Surah Qadr, the best time to get close to Allah in the whole year is in the night of Qadr, which is the last 10 nights. So this is the interrelationship. It is the interrelationship of the surah with the previous surah, that the previous surah tells us we knew not, Allah taught us. This surah tells us what we learn. We learn about the greatness of this night. The last surah ended off with wasjud waqtarib, gain closeness and proximity to Allah by prostrating to Allah. And when is the best time? We learn that in this surah, that the best time to gain the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be in the nights of Laylatul Qadr, in one of the odd nights of Laylatul Qadr. May Allah give us the opportunity of gaining this proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these last 10 nights. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم.